So here we have to prove this equation. This has been given. Take log on both sides. So you will get log of y will be equal to log of m cube into n 4, n is to power 4 divided by 16 p square. So this division will be converted into subtraction. You will get log of m cube n is to power 4 minus log of 16 p square. So this multiplication will be converted into addition. So we will get log of m cube plus log of n is to power 4 minus, here again you can see multiplication, this is 16 multiplied by p square. Because we are having minus here, it is better to insert a bracket. It will be log of 16 plus log of p square. You see, multiplication is converted into addition. So now if you simplify this 3, you will write in front, that is multiply, this is log n is to power 4, so this 4 will come in front. So it will be 3 times of log m plus 4 times of log n minus. So this, let us open the bracket. So it will be minus log 16. 16 you can write as 2 raised to power 4. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. It will be 16. Because of this minus, here also sign will change. It will be minus log p square. Okay. So now all this we can rub. This we have simplified. So now you will get, so this will be 3 times log m plus 4 times of log n, okay, minus this 4. If you simplify, you have to write in front, that is you have to multiply. It will be minus 4 times of log 2 minus, similarly this 2 will come here, minus 2 times of log p. Now you can transfer both of these terms from right hand side to the left hand side. So we will get 4 times of log 2 plus 2 times of log p plus log y is equal to 3 times of log m plus 4 times of log n, which is exactly what we have to prove. Hence proved. Okay, let us take up the next question. So again we have to prove, we can take log on both sides. So we will get log of p will be equal to log of 50 times v square, y square raised to power 3 divided by 81 x cube. So division will be converted to subtraction. So it will be log of minus. So now if you simplify this 3, you can write in front, that is you have to multiply. So this will be 3 times of log 50 multiplied by y square minus, because you are having minus sign, I am inserting a bracket to avoid mistakes due to sign. Here you can see 81 multiplied by x cube. So this multiplication here will convert into addition. So we will get here log of 81 plus log of x cube. Okay. Similarly here you can see 50 multiplied by y square. So this multiplication will be converted into addition. So we will get 3 times of log 50. And this 3 you have to multiply both with log 50 as well as with log y square, because 3 is to multiply it with the whole expression, with the whole term here. Okay. So we'll get 3 times of log 50 plus 3 times of log y square. So this 81 you can write as 9 raised to power 2. Okay. So this will be 9 square. But 9 we don't have to prove, we want log 3. So in terms of log 3, 81 will be, in terms of 3, it will be 3 raised to power 4, isn't it? You can see here 27 into 3 is 81. So 81 you can write as 3 raised to power 4. So if you do like this and you simplify for log, this 4 you will have to write in front. So you will get here minus 4 times of log 3 plus, similarly here this 3 will come here, 3 times of log x. Okay. So now this will be 3 times of log 50. 50 you can write as 5 into 10. 50 I am writing as 5 into 10. Then this 2 you will have to write here. So it will be 2 multiplied by 3, 6. Plus 6 times of log y. Okay. Then this is minus 4 log 3. Because of this minus, here also sign will change. It will be minus 3 times of log x. You can see that I am not writing base. If I am not writing any base, then that automatically means that the base is 10. In the question, they have written 10 every time. But even if the 10 base is not indicated, it is understood that the base is 10. For example, here, this is log of p and base is 10. So now, this multiplication will be converted into addition. So we'll get 3 times of log 5 plus this 3 again you have to multiply it. 3 times of log 10 plus 6 times of log y minus 4 times of log 3 minus 3 times of log x. As I have said, base is 10. When the base and this number they are same, it means it is equal to 1. 1 multiplied by 3 will be 3. So we will get here a constant 3. This 5 is 10 upon 2. You can write 5 as 10 upon 2 like this. Division is converted into subtraction. So we will get 3 times of log 10 minus, again 3 will be multiplied, 3 times of log 2 plus 3 plus 6 times of log y minus 4 times of log 3 minus 3 times of log x. Okay, as I have told you many times before, that when the base and number are same, then it will evaluate to 1. If the base is not indicated, that means the base is 10. 1 multiplied by 3 will be 3. So here we can write 3. Now you can see you are already having 1 3 here. So 3 plus 3 will be 6. So we can write here directly 6. Now 6 times of log y. So in the expression that you have to prove, you want log p, then x and y on one side. So that means this log y you can transfer from the right hand side to the left hand side. And similarly, what is the other term? Log x. So this x you can transfer from right hand side to the left hand side. Okay, so if you bring it this side, it will be minus 6 times of log y. So here you are having log p. So it will be log p. Log p means log of p minus 6 times of log y. And if you bring this from right to left hand side, this term will become plus 3 times of log x. So this will be plus 3 times of log of x. Okay, and then you will be left with 6 minus 3 times of log 2 minus 4 times of log 3. So you can check on the right hand side, you are having 6 minus 3 times of log 2 minus 4 times of log 3. So like this way you can prove. This is what we had to prove. Okay, next problem. So this equation has been given to us, x square plus y square is equal to 23xy. And we have to prove this equation. Okay, so you can make use of algebraic identity here. So why I am saying to make use of algebraic identity? Because here you are having 23xy. So if you take log, it will be log of 23 plus log of x plus log of y. So log of 23, it will be difficult, and there is no log of 23 here. So you should think that how to get rid of this 23. You can get it of 23 by here making use of algebraic identity x square plus y square. So you must be knowing this identity x plus y whole square is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. So what will be x square plus y square? You can transfer this 2xy from right hand side to left hand side. Then instead of x square plus y square, you can write here x plus y whole square minus 2 times xy. This is equal to 23xy. Now if we transfer this minus 2xy from left to right, it will become 25xy. So we will get here x plus y whole square is equal to 25 times xy. Sorry, like this. X plus y, this is x plus y whole square. Okay. So whatever expression has been given to you, you can write it in this manner. So here you will get, you can write it like this. X plus y whole square is equal to 25 times of xy. Okay. So now it will be a bit easier for us. So now if you take log on both sides, you will get log of x plus y whole square is equal to log of this side. You can see two multiplication, log 25, you will get log 25 plus log x plus log y, because in the term you are having 25 multiplied by x multiplied by y. There are two times multiplication, so both multiplication will be converted into addition. You will get log of 25 plus log x plus log y. So now this 25, you can write as 5 raised to power 2, 5 square. Now if you simplify, then this 2 you can write here. So this will become 2 times of log 5. So here you will get 2 times of log 5. This 2 again, you will write in front. So you will get 2 times of log x plus y is equal to 2 times of log 5 plus log of x plus log of y. So you can transfer this 2 log 5, 2 times of log 5 from right hand side to left hand side. You will get 2 times of log of x plus y minus 2 times of log 5. Log 5 means log of 5. Then equal to, and then log of x plus log of y. So now as per the laws of logarithm, the basics that you must be knowing already, in case you see a minus sign, so that actually means the division, because when we take log, then division only is converted into subtraction. Okay, so this much basic you must know. First you can take this 2 as common factor, like this, as I am doing, insert a bracket. You will get log of x plus y minus log of 5 equal to log of x plus log of y, like this. So as you have to prove in the as per the question, this 2 you can transfer from left side to right side. So this multiplication will be converted into division. So directly here only I am writing 1 upon 2 and inserting a bracket, because this 2 if you transfer on that side, it will become 1 upon 2. So now here you can see a subtraction sign, minus. This means you want to say upon 5. Then only you can get a minus here. You can put a bracket like this. Okay, hence proved. Like this you have to do. So again, this is a proving question. We have to prove this expression, this equation. Now here you can see a square plus b square is equal to 11ab. Here you can see a minus b. So they mean to say that both a and b are greater than 0. Otherwise this will be, if they are not greater than 0, if they are equal to 0, then here you will get 0. So this is the expression given. So let us try to make use of identity where we can get a minus b. because here we want a minus b. So we can make use of this identity. A minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Now if you transfer this minus 2ab from right to left, it will become plus a minus b whole square plus 2ab is equal to a square plus b square. So you can write this here. So instead of a square plus b square is equal to 11ab, we can write this a minus b whole square plus 2ab is equal to 11ab. So now you can take log on both sides. Before taking log on both sides, you can transfer this 2ab from left to right. So here you will get 11 minus 2, you will get 9 times of ab. So here I am writing 9 times of ab like this. Okay, so now if you take log on both sides, log of a minus b whole square is equal to, here you can see 9 multiplied by a multiplied by b, so it will be log of 9 plus log of a plus log of b. Multiplication is converted into addition. 2 multiplication, you will get 2 addition here. So this 9 you can write as 3 square. If you simplify for log, this 2 will come in front, that is you have to multiply, so you will get 2 times of, like this, log of a minus b. So now this 2 also you can write here, you will get 2 times of log 3. This 2 times of log 3 you can transfer from right hand side to left hand side, you will get 2 times of log a minus b minus 2 times of log 3 is equal to log of a plus log of b. You can take 2 common factor. So if you take 2 common factor, you will have to insert bracket like this. This 2 if you transfer from left to right hand side, multiplication will become division, so you will get 1 upon 2 multiplied by log of a plus log of b. Now on the left hand side you can see subtraction. As you know, as per laws of logarithms, division is converted into subtraction. So this will be log of a minus b upon 3. If you take log, this will be log of a minus b minus log of 3. So this minus you can convert into division like this. This is equal to half times of log of a plus log of b. So this is exactly what we have to prove. So like this you can do easily. So this is the expression given. We have to write it in the form in which log is not there. It is free from log. We have to get rid of these logs. So as you know, laws of logarithm, if you are seeing minus here, it means in the original expression there must be division. You can write it like this. This you can write, this expression you can write as log of s minus log of pi. So here you can take 2 common factor. It will be log of 2 plus log of r. Okay, so now this means that you want to say on the right hand side, or let me write left hand side once again, log of s upon pi is equal to 2 times of, if you see addition here, it means there must have been multiplication. So it will be log of 2 multiplied by r. This log of 2 times r, if you simplify, it will be log of 2 plus log of r. So that only I have written here. So this 2 you can transfer from, if you are writing 2 here, that means it is power or index of the original sum of the original term, of the original expression. That means the original expression must be 2r whole square. So this 2 you have written here. Okay, so like this, if this is the expression given and you take log of it, then this 2 will come here, that is you have to multiply it by 2, and then it will be log of 2 plus log of r. So now you can see that this equal to sign, on the left hand side you are having log of s upon pi, and on the right hand side you are having 2r whole square. and this equal to sign. This means that both of these must be equal. That is, S upon pi must be equal to 2r whole square. So this means if you open this bracket, it will become 4r square. Or if you want, you can rearrange it further. If you rearrange it further, then this pi you can transfer from left side to right hand side. On the left hand side it is division. On the right hand side it will become multiplication. So S will be equal to 4 pi r square. So this is what the original expression was. And if you take log on both sides, then you will get this expression. So what is this formula? What is this relation? This is for the surface area of a sphere. Okay, surface area of a sphere is 4 pi r square, and if you take volume, it will be 4 upon 3 pi r cube. Okay, so next question we'll take up. So this is the given expression. Again, we have to get rid of this log. So as per laws of logarithm, if 2 is written here, that means it in the original expression it must be x square. That is the basic. So it must be having log of x square base 10. Okay. So here you can see addition. It means in the original expression there must have been a multiplication. So originally it must be like this, x square into y. Okay. So on the right hand side you are having 2 like this. So what does this means? As we have discussed in the first part, it means if you raise 10 to the power 2, then you will get x square y. In other words, x square y must be equal to 10 raised to power 2, that is 100. Okay. So this is the relation. Or if you want to rearrange, then you can say y is equal to 100 upon x square. Okay. Same thing. So this is your correct answer. Let us do the next part. So we have to prove that x is equal to y. So if you open the bracket, you will get here half times of log x plus half times of log y. So this will be x raised to power 1 by 2. That is why you are writing 1 by 2 here. So you can write it like this. Similarly, this you can transfer here. So you will get log of root x plus log of under root y. So you can see here addition. That means originally there must be multiplication, root of x multiplied by root of y. That is when you simplify for log, then this multiplication will be converted into addition. So we will get log of under root x plus log of under root y. So in other words, you can say log of under root xy like this. And on the left hand side, you are having log of x plus y upon 2. This is equal to sign. So when you are having equal to sign between the logs on both sides, it means that x plus y upon 2 must be equal to under root xy. So you can rewrite it like this. It is simply a matter of rearranging. So if log are equal, it is log on both sides are equal, it means x plus y upon 2 is equal to under root xy. This is the meaning. You can transfer this 2 from left hand side to the right hand side, then it will be multiply. Okay. So now you can take square on both sides. So now if you take square on both sides, you will get x square plus 2xy plus y square will be equal to 4 times of xy. Okay. That is, you want to say that if you transfer this 2xy from left to right, it will become 4 minus 2, that is 2xy. So x square plus y square is equal to 2xy. So here you can transfer 2xy from right to left hand side, you will get x square minus 2xy plus y square is equal to 0. So here you can make use of algebraic identity. X square minus 2xy plus y square you can write like this. X minus y whole square is equal to 0. So if you take square root on both sides, you will get x minus y is equal to 0, because this side square root will get cancelled by 2. Or if you want, I will write like this. This is what I am saying. So this radical sign means power is 1 upon 2. So like this. And this square root of 0 will be 0 only. So this 2 will cancel. That is x minus y is equal to 0. If you transfer this minus y from left to right, you will get x is equal to y. Okay, that's how you can do it. So we have to solve for x. That is determine the value of x. So here you can write it like this. Log of x base 10, transfer this log 3 from right to left. Log of 3 base 10 is equal to 1. So in terms of log, if you are having minus sign, it means in the original expression there must be division. It will be x upon 3. This one you can write as log of 10 base 10. So if the two logs are equal, then that means that x upon 3 must be equal to 10. This implies that x will be equal to 30. Like this you can solve it. Now here this 36 you can write as 6 square, isn't it? So instead of 36 I am writing here 6 square. So this 5 you can write as 10 upon 2. So this right hand side I am rewriting, left hand side let it be like this only. So you will get 2 times of this. Division means it will be subtraction. Log of 10 minus 2 times of log 2. So this 2 will come here, you will get 2 times of log 6. Now this 6 means 3 into 2. In terms of log, it will be addition. This log 10 base 10 is 1, 2 into 1 is 2. Log of 3, so 2 times of log of 3 plus log of 2, so it will be 2 times of log of 2. So this will cancel out, and minus 3 and plus 2, you will get minus times of log 3. This will cancel. So what you will get finally is, let me rub this part, 2 minus log of 3, like this. So on the left hand side also you are having 2, on the right hand side also you can have 2, you are having 2, so this you can cancel. You will get minus log of x is equal to minus log of 3. This minus will cancel. If log x is equal to log 3, that means x must be equal to 3. This will be your answer. Here you can see 3. That means in the original expression, this 3 must be present as an index. So it must have been 3x minus 1 is equal to log 2 raised to power 3. Base is 10. So if the logs are equal, you can see here equal to sign. It means 3x minus 1 must be equal to 2 raised to power 3. That is, 2 raised to power 3 means 8. So 3 times of x, if you transfer minus 1 from left to right, it will be 8 plus 1 is equal to 9. This means x must be equal to 3. So if you are seeing subtraction, that means in the original expression, there must have been division. So you can write it like this. Divided by, and on the right hand side you are having 2, so this 2 you can write as 2 into 1. How can you get 1? 2 into 1 is 2, but this 1 you can also write as log of 10, isn't it? If the base and number are same, base is 10, then you will get 1. So if you are having this expression 2 into log of 10, so this means you want to say log of 10 raised to power 2, base is 10. So this must be index. So this 2 you can shift here. On the left hand side you are having. So now this means if log, 2 log are same, 2 log are equal, I mean, you are having here equal to sign. It means that this 2 expression must be equal. That is 10x plus 5 upon x minus 4 will be equal to 10 raised to power 2. 10 raised to power 2 means 100. So now you can simplify this further. If you simplify, then you will get 10x plus 5 is equal to 100 multiplied by x minus 4. This will be equal to 100x minus 400. This 10x you can transfer from left to right. 100 minus 10 you will get 90x. 400 you can transfer from right to left. Minus 400 will become plus 400. You will get 400 plus 5 equal to 405 by 90. So if you want, you can simplify further. 2 times. Why 2 times? 5. 1 5. Okay. 5 8 40. 5 1 5. So this will be by 9, you can simplify. 9 2 times 9 9 81. So you will get equal to, we are already having 9 upon 2. This will be value of x. Like this you can do. This log of 2x minus 3 you can transfer from right to left. You will get log base 2 log of x minus 1. This will be minus log of 2x minus 3 base 2 is equal to 1. So if you are having subtraction, it means in the original expression there must have been division. Log base 2, it must have been something like this. So now see the expression carefully. What it means? It means 2 raised to power 1, this is 1, should be equal to x minus 1 upon 2x minus 3, because 2 is the base. So 2 raised to power 1 will be 2 only. I'm rubbing this. If you transfer 2x minus 3 from right to left, there will be multiplication. So you will get 4x minus 6. Okay. And then this you can rub out. This 2 you can rub out. This 2x minus 3. So this x you can transfer from left to right. You will get 3x. Is equal to this minus 6 from right to left, it will be plus 6. 6 minus 1 is 5. So this implies that x should be equal to 5 upon 3. Like this you can do. So now let us solve this part. You can see plus sign. So plus means there must have been multiplication. It must have been root x plus 1, like this, multiplied by root x minus 1, and you are taking log of whole thing. So then only this multiplication will be converted into addition. So this means log of this is a plus b into a minus b. So this will be equal to a square minus b square. Imagine this root x as 1 as a and 1 as b. So this is a plus b into a minus b. Root x square will be x minus 1 square will be 1. And 1 you can write as log 10. When the base is not indicated, it is 10. And if base and number are same, it is equal to 1. So instead of 1, you can write 10. If two logs are equal, that means x minus 1 must be equal to 10. Minus 1 you can transfer from left to right. You will get x is equal to 11. This will be your answer. Okay? So P you know, Q has been given, Q you know, and this expression you know. And you have to find x. So let us substitute the values of P and Q. So we will get here 2 times of log base 10, x plus 1 is equal to 2 times of let me use the other marker. So now here, instead of p, you can write here log of 20 base 10 minus, instead of q, you can write here log of 25 base 10. So if you are having 2 here in multiplication, that means this 2 must be index. So this 2 you can transfer. It will be log of 20 square minus log of 25, you can write as 5 square. Similarly, this side, on the right hand side also, 2 you can move to index. So you will get log of x plus 1 whole square, base is 10. So now 20 square, so this will be 400. I am writing here 400 minus log of 5 square. So let it be 25 only. Previously I have written it 5 square. Let it be 25. We are having minus. So this minus means there must have been division. So you can write it like this. 400 by 25. And here you are having log of x plus 1 whole square base 10. So you can see that if logs are equal, then this expression must be equal. That is, x plus 1 whole square must be equal to 400 divided by 25. Now this 400, you know, it is 20 square and 25 is 5 square. So you can say that x plus 1 whole square is equal to 20 upon 5 whole square, like this. So this square you can cancel. That means you want to say that x plus 1 is equal to 20 upon 5. 20 upon 5 means 4. So x will be equal to 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. This will be your answer. X is equal to 3.